six-time Bathurst winner, five-time supercar champ, Hall of Famer, all-time great. Not bad for a kid from Wyong. Mark Skaife started out in a Nissan, riding shotgun with gentleman Jim Richards.
You're a pack of arseholes.
Before snagging his first championship in 92. And having beaten them, he then joined them, becoming the heir to Peter Brock's Holden throne before building his own dynasty.
Sensational!
And he made it look easy. Well, except for this little love tap.
And you get hit very hard from behind.
And this prank.
Now, I have never seen anything quite like that.
And bloody hell.
Into the wall, a huge accident here!
Anyway, after retirement, Skaife struggled to stay away from the track, tinkering with everything from course design to the running of the sport itself. And of course, he's brought his trademark laid-back style to the commentary booth.
He's in the fence!
All up, he's crammed a hell of a lot in. In fact, it'd make a pretty good book. Huh. Will you look at that?
Well, Mark Skaife's the proud papa of a bouncing baby book, and he joins us now. Firstly, congrats on the book, Mark, but the cover says a complete illustrated autobiography. Normally, the person themselves writes the autobiography, but you've done something really clever. You've got a bunch of friends and colleagues to contribute, and they almost give you a roast. Is it fair to say that decision totally backfired?
Well, evening, Lisa. Yes, it did. Absolutely backfired. In fact, if you go through it, there's a lot of expletives. They've called me a very below average loser. They've called me a serial pest. They've called me a giant pain in the backside. It's certainly come back to haunt me. There's no doubt about that.
Yeah, I've actually got some of the character references here. You don't suffer fools, apparently. You're a bit of a bastard on the track. You love a nice red as long as someone else is paying. Have I missed anything?
No, and that's a little more of the content that my colleagues have provided. Look, it's been fantastic. There's been some of those colleagues, like Roland Dane, that I spent most of my time racing against, who ended up turning into a friend when I ended up driving for him. But there's some great stories amongst those people. And I did say to them when they were going to contribute that I wasn't going to edit anything. So I still stand by that.
Skaife, you're obviously an amazing driver and now a great broadcaster, except if you're broadcasting with you. Because tell us about when you left your good mate, Neil Crompton, absolutely hanging out to dry on pit lane in Bathurst.
Well, we were hosting a lot of shows, Tommy, at the time, and we were doing V8 Extra, panel beaters, stick shift for Triple M on a Saturday morning. We had all these different shows going, and as it turned out, the producers changed the name of our Friday night show to Pit Lane Live on the 7 Network. And we were sitting there together. We'd come back from an ad break, and it was like someone wiped a magnet over his hard drive. He could not remember what the name of the show was. And I'm sure you guys would know, I bet you've all done it, where there's just had that moment in time where you're a bunny in the headlights and you go, oh, my God, I can't remember the name of the show. And all I did was laugh. I sat next to him and let him go. I didn't try to bail him out. I was co-hosting, but it's one of the funniest things I've ever been involved in. And still to this day, he recalls it whenever we have a beer.
Skaife, that bunny in the headlights, that's PVO all the time. Hey, mate, you've raced against obviously some of the best of all time, which yourself is included. But can you talk to us about some of the people you raced with and against? Is there any that really stood out above the pack?
Oh, look, I've been really lucky, Tommy. You know, the people that I raced against, I was joining the series when Brock, Richards, Perkins, Bond, Grice, all those guys were sort of finishing their careers. And then I got to race against guys like Glenn Seaton, Paul Radisich, John Bow, right through to Craig Lowndes, Marcus Ambrose, Russell Ingall, Garth Tander, you name them. I've been really fortunate. And even in the modern era, I raced a lot against, you know, guys like Jamie Wincup, who's won 7 championships. So throughout that time, it's been great. The level of competition in this country, we've got the best touring car drivers in the world. And to race against them over that period has been fantastic. Jim Richards, for me, is probably the one that stands out. You know, other than being a Kiwi, he's actually a really good bloke. And and he's a Jekyll and Hyde. How he ever got Gentleman Jim, I'd never know, because one of the hardest racers I've ever been around. He's a very, very competitive guy. Probably the world's best touring car driver in the late 90s.
You basically grew up in an auto shop. I assume that helps when you want to be a race car driver, right?
Well, it does, Peter. I think, you know, my dad taught me so much about cars and car racing and being around the automotive game. It's obviously very blokey, and it's a dependent part of understanding cars. I mean, there's a lot of race drivers that don't necessarily understand the cars that well, but it always served me well. And I think in the background of that, you have some mechanical sympathy, you have some understanding of how the car works, and from a engineering standpoint, you've got a better feel for it. So that definitely served me well, no doubt.
Mark, you're an absolute legend of the track, but we have our own legend of the track, Tommy Little, here, who's done some racing himself. He hasn't brought it up for some reason. Do you know why that would be?
Skaife taught me.
Well, look, I did teach him. It's not my proudest moment, but I did teach him. He actually did a really good job, but it was a lot of fun. It was a great week for all the celebs.
No, come on, mate. Be honest.
Be frank.
Be honest.
Skaife, I rode off three cars.
Yeah, you knocked some gear around, you got beaten by a lot of girls, and you spent a lot of time off the road. So if you went through the checklist, you probably didn't really get much of a pass mark, Tommy.
I got beaten by the safety car.
At least he's being honest now. Well, Mark's book is available from Tuesday. Thanks so much for joining us, Mark.
Thanks, Lisa.